Hello everybody, another podcast. I'm from the Digital Robotics team. The team was started by Pavel Voskov. He owns the robot and all the components of the all the parts, which cost a lot of money and so on. I'm only doing the software, which is over 3 years. And also in our team are my son with me always, driving and going behind the robot and all. Peter's brother. Was the robot the last year? Yes, this was the optimistic version for ready for sun, and then we made it like this. Okay, so this year we just did a lot of the construction. You can see probably that this frame is slightly bigger. There is bigger space, so you can slightly better take it with yourself and so on. Also, Paolo has a new 3D printer, so it's 3D printed right now. See a lot of parts printed and so on. So, on the back side, you can see also some LEDs which are showing you because we are always following the robot from the back side. So, also, we have here these LEDs and they are showing us what the robot is doing. Yes, I will show them the blocks and so on. Also, the button is right now here. We have also two additional sensors on the board. We also implemented some first version of the back. If you are thinking we are going the wrong way, you can turn back and turn to the navigation point and then go forward. It has not always a good towards. This was the robot changes which we do for the robot. Slides last year sometime. These are our hardware design. We are being the most ambitious, I hope. We have four of them, Arduino Mega, two nanos, and one Arduino Mini. Because always when I ask about to get some hardware there, we always put one Arduino and all the hardware. So we have two displays, yes, LCD and OLED display. These are the LED strips, yes, with Arduino and all the combat. Arduino. And then last year we had the Raspberry Pi 3, and this year we changed it for a Raspberry Pi 4. I will show you why and the difference. And then there are additional one Arduino is controlling the motors, it's the control board, and we also have a barrel sensor, it was not there last year, and emergency button, sonar and pipe, camera, and we are keeping the air. Okay, so here is just the list of all the hardware, how to do it, and so on. Everything. Okay, this is the comparison between Android and Raspberry. So the story with Android started also last year. We had Android, but we didn't use it. I liked also Raspberry because of open source and big community and so on. But the selling point for Android is that it's faster. It's really 6 times faster. This is the comparison to best Raspberry and 3 Androids which are on the market. Yes. And what is the difference? Is 3 Android can run 2 GHz, Raspberry is 1 or 2 GHz, and it has 8 cores, and it has 2 times as much RAM, and the RAM is 2 times faster. And also the flash, it can use a flash which is probably 2 times faster than the micro SD and the Raspberry. So everything is faster, and we finally went. Our image processing algorithm, which is passing through all the pixels of the image and doing some distance to some cluster centers, is running this speed. So there is no difference between Raspberry 2 and Raspberry 3. But for the Android, it is really 5 times, 6 times faster. So it was also surprising for me. And also writing images to this was 3 times faster. And on the Raspberry 2, we are running just 100% CPU, and we had a lot of processing lags, so just everything stopped, all the threads, and we just got the next instruction after 12 seconds also. So the robot was moving just forward for 12 seconds and doing nothing else. And for Raspberry 3, there were some situations where it goes to second status of pages last year and so on. But right now with Android you really see a maximum of 100 milliseconds of such length. So the story of Android started in such a way that Palo Wall was near Žilina for 1 week on vacation holidays. And we agreed that on Friday we will come to Žilina, and as it directly in the park. And then I was waiting, I was developing until Friday. Then Friday, about the lunch, I sent an email to Pavel. Okay, I'm going to do it in the park, just upload the source codes and so on. And he just wrote me an SMS or called me back. Sorry, but I forgot the Raspberry in Bratislava. Yes, and he was just close to Žilina, and there was no way how to bring on the Friday the Raspberry there and so on. But he said, I have the Odroid with me. So he said, okay, let's try to do the migration to Odroid in just 2 hours until I will arrive to Žilina and so on. So let's try it, yes? So then we spent approximately about 5 hours to do the migration. And then we had additional problems with camera and so on and so on. But then when we saw the speed, we just said, okay, no more battery, and we need this just to have to play with the other things and so on. Okay, the software we are using is not Raspbian, it's Ubuntu right now. It's OpenCV. We have some geographic library for calculation distances. Some Apache for lodging, for C things. And we have 8 threads for all the sensors and capturing and so on. Then on the second slide is also more about the software blocks. So here are independent threads. VDAR can capture seven blocks of data for every angle 7 times per second. Camera captures about 30 frames per second. And we can process this data at 35 milliseconds. Not every, but mostly we can process every frame and update it in our model. Then there's GPS thread and thread communicating with the control board, and one thread dedicated only to saving images to disk. It's not writing every image, but 3 times per second we are writing images, so we have about 4 gigabytes of data from yesterday, and we can analyze. Okay, the main processing thread looks like this. So it will update the internal grid from the vision data and from the LiDAR data which are ready. This is doing for 20 milliseconds, and then it's calculating all the other output data we need for navigation. Then we also capture the GPS and compass data, and when it is ready, and after 20 milliseconds, we will go and calculate the navigation angle where it should go. Then we will look to the grid, we just updated here, how many obstacles are around, and calculate some angles. And then we will do the decision what to do in this step. We can do the avoidance of obstacles, which we do if there is really some obstacle which is a bit very closely. We always do this first. So we calculate minimum maximum angle of some obstacles from left side and right side, and we don't go straight. Just go with the algorithm which was in place just last year, and it worked fine. And then we need for the map and for the navigation some compass calibration. Yes. So our compass is not telling you where is the plot and so on. So we need to calibrate the relative direction from the compass with the direction given by the GPS. Yes. So where we know the north and we know where the goals and navigation points. So this is, we are every 30 to 3 minutes are doing some calibration that with the robot, okay, if there is no obstacle, and otherwise you will just go here. If there is no obstacle, just go straight for 7 seconds and try to look for the angles. Yes. Then write the calibration angles which we use then for all the other ways. So runway behavior is some features, just a quick implementation, because we really like the going back of the robot and just fixing the position, but okay, we have a metric time with this. And we also did only, if you see that the direction you should go, you are going, it's really different, more than 30 angles or 30 degrees, and then just go backwards slightly and drive it into this button by going back and forward and so on. So, but okay, because of this, not get a 1 point in the competition platform. There is something missing there. Okay, and then the navigation. So if you see there is no obstacle, we should go there. We are going there, so let's go on there in the direction. That's simple. And we are using it. There are some images. I don't go too much with detail from the VR vision. That is the visualization. If VR gives us some data, where are the obstacles? If something is very closely, we try to avoid these degrees and try to choose the direction to go there. If something is very close, we will stop based on the VR condition. This is just visual approach. What we do is we draw several lines and points, and for every point around the point, we try to look for pixels, and based on some clusters, which are taken from the samples, we have samples of how a road should look like and how a grass should look like. And then we are coloring every image with blue and red to see where we see the image, we see a road. So on, based on this, the robot knows how far is an obstacle like that. There are some issues, there's an algorithm that you can see. Sometimes here is a mud, and you can not handle the correct. In such situation, you should take this role because there are in the end. This line could not be connected under the end because there are some potential controls. Just the idea. Okay, so what we did this year, or it was prepared already last year, I didn't work because of not enough testing and the issues with the compass calibration. Well, we have predefined waypoints. The position of the waypoints is taken from OpenStreetMap. Yes, and we are manually putting for every route a string, how the robot should go. That is a string for a route around 3 or so. So take these 2 points, then there should be some pickup. The star one is pickup. Then additionally go to additional points. Then there is drop off and additional points. Just to come back. Yes, so this was our approach, how we work with navigation. So you can all, because we are doing it, you can all choose how the robot should turn and so on and think about it and plan the route. If you know there is too much grass on this route, but not so much in this one, so you can choose or prepare additionally so you have more information about the type of route for the road. Okay, we also are building this year this local grid. So we are around the robot. Every information we get from the vision sensor and from the radar we are putting in the map. These red ones means that there is some obstacle detected by that. Blue is an obstacle detected with grass or something like that. Off-road. Yes. So the robot, you see the stride angle of the vision, which is only 60 degrees. But the reader could really see much wider angle, so and even like we are moving, we're going forward and building it up, and we are also saving to this, and also how that change and so on. So 1 pixel on this map is 10 centimeters, and we have an array of 100 meters left. Okay, then. Such a map we can build because we are also using the GPS coordinates to fix internal geometry, which is not quite good in the robot. So, but okay, then we really need a correct GPS position to draw correct map and also draw the local map correctly with the obstacles. So you see that here probably was some grass detected, but then the robot turned slightly, did not detect anything, and cleared the map, and so on. So and on the other side, we can't see the end of the road, so we will put it out here, because it's driving only in the where you have seen the points in the distance, and maybe 4 meters before the robot is driving. Sees. Sometimes if he is moving in a different position, then he can draw several times from different images, incorrect the positions. problems. We had poor GPS performance, for sure, was the issue also because we used the compass calibration. We are also dependent very much on the GPS performance. And also, we could not pick up and drop off points in the first round. Then the points were changed to a place where there was not so much trees, it was much better. Yes. So, these local traps, yes, this, what we have seen is these places for benches, they were not installed. And really, if we had the wrong navigation angle, we just went there and then saw something like this from both sides of the grass, and we just need to stop and go back. But this was not even so terrible to use the local maps for some wrong navigation. We just still use the local map, but for some left navigation on the base of the angles. Okay. And also, we implemented there some filtering, which on the end was some bug that he just did not. And go around the grass and jump directly on the ground and so on. Compass display didn't work this year. On the round two, we had an issue. We could not connect to the robot. Yes, so we spent 30 minutes just trying to reboot the robot and again, we are not able to use my phone to connect. So we are not out. Okay, so we do not start because of this. Okay, the vision. This is the standard problem. We can detect grass if there is enough green color, yes, but if there is some mud, if it is some brown or yellow, we can't differentiate between the road and the grass. Yes. So this is for our robot, it's just completely okay to go that way because it's the same color. And I would really like to see if somebody can train the network, the neural network, to really differentiate such problem. I have a look on the HSV space, and the hue saturation and so on, and these different games to the same colors like the road, and not being ridiculous. We had also some segmentation fault. So when we came for the homologation and just playing around with the robot, I received a segmentation fault, and I really didn't know where it is. But I got this error also 2 weeks ago. It was not happening very often. And then I read on the internet that you can use GDB, techno debugger, for it. And then we are starting always the application with the GDB, or the always 4 rounds. And if you will then get such error, you can just place a command vector list, and it will show you where the error occurred. So it was in LiDAR output, draw output. So LiDAR driving images had some issue. And you can choose it, okay, I would like to see this procedure, go next. And then you can look directly on this frame, and it will show you, okay, and this line, you have some issues. It was directly placing some points, this is the way recommended by the OpenCV, but I did not test the coordinates, because I expected to say, if the LiDAR is maximum 3 meters before me, I can always draw this image. But then I realized that, okay, there's been an issue. I tried to put a point for 483, but the image was only 640 to 480, yes, so 3 points below the image. And this is just the issue. It's really hard to find, but with this debugger, it was pretty easy to fix. Okay, which is some examples, but I'm not sure.
We opened the box one and then go to this one.
This was how we approached Cogito in the round zero. The robot was seen on the leader, you can see that there is some obstacle here around. This is how we are visually using a leader. So this is before the robot, and here is the information about the quality. This is the quality information to filter some sun objects. What you can see also on this image is that our detection algorithm can detect a robot only by the vision. Yes, so we see this is too dark, it could not be a road and it could not be a grass. Yes, the grass should be like this, blue one, and this is not the correct road. So we can also use the vision method to avoid this robot.
What are the white light ones?
The green ones are the ones this angle we will go, and this white we could also go to avoid this robot, but we did not choose this because this general is short. The robot is going the direction. On the middle image you can see that it's going on the here you can see also that this is also grass on the left side, so it is going here.
You are going to the center of the green segment.
Yes, yes, this is the approach. And if the, there is no obstacle, then we are using the navigation. So, like in this picture, we could use the navigation, for example. But there is still some obstacle on the level. Here you can see that some angle we used for navigation is minus one with the software bug, which I was not aware about, and the robot is going forward. And in this situation, we see, okay, probably I should escape in this. Direction, but still he was doing nothing, and then he just went into the grass. This is how we, what are the issues we detect in the map. Now our algorithm here is the map. Yes, here is nice grass, really green. So the issue is really, we see this is zero. It is the same, yes, we can't make it here. Yes, all of this. You load it down to three. I'm not sure if that robot could do this. So you are going to the whole round, after the bell at the beginning. If we have a good GPS navigation, the robot will go right here, but if we think that I should go like this to the right side, it will be go here and all the road. We just turned back incorrectly and went back, so then we again received an image that we should. The right way was to go to the right side. Based on the angles, he would choose this left, but because of the software bug, it just went directly straight and on the grass. But what is interesting on this picture is that you can see what our camera is doing. If there is also a rope and also the grass, the grass is really clean and green and so on, and we can really detect it without any issues. But if on the issue, on the image, it's only the green grass, the camera will put a gray color. It will, the green part of the image of the color will go down. It is much grayer, and then we can't detect it correctly. Yes. So the robot always, the camera should always see, just to work with the classification, we should always see also part of the robot. Okay, this is just a vision detection. If we are approaching the pickup place, you can see here also that the color, this orange color was not detected as a road nor a grass, so we avoid if you see it on the road. This is how the robot is approaching it. And the robot. Here, yes. Then, when we are after this pickup, the robot knows that the navigation angle is go left. tries to turn left and sees, okay, there is a grass, I should avoid going forward because it detects a big angle. Right now I see I can go also left, so it will slightly turn probably and also the grass, and this is how it will avoid. Yes. And he will drive all these pixels to a local green. Yes. This is how we see. Situation. This is how an internal grid looks like. On this you can see that here this bigger circle is from here, but we are shrinking it just to avoid the obstacles sooner, and then the camera is just from this point of view looking to a much right distance, which is probably not good. So it's not a correct see that in the internal image, on the left side you see a grass which is somehow green, and we are going closer, and so on. This is because the, how the camera works, it will not see so much, and so on. Here somebody appears on the right side. Okay. Okay. Here was some changing of the position of the GPS, so there was some jump completely, and the road is moving more left right now. And here is the beacon, a lot of people appearing around, which are appearing afterwards after the pickup. Yes. And then you can see what the robot did after the pickup. This was the grass which appeared on the left side of the robot, and then going forward into the crossing, and how he corrected the internal model and so on, because it is not quite consistent, yes, how we did it. Okay, this is just for this year as a change, just to let's try into some experiment with the internal model, and actually we have a lot of that. You can see that somebody was walking around the robot, so he has a long the sources we will for sure put GitHub, and you can find them later. Right now there are the sources from the last year. And just thank you if you have any questions.
Thank you. Any questions, please?
How do you remove information from the local grid?
We don't have any heat map. We are just putting the information, the last information we see is put there. So
you already know.
We always overwrite, yes. So this is just how we don't need to be very consistent and